Next on PIJN News, Dr. Chaps reports on these important issues.
Today is Ladies Day. We interview three authors, including April Shenandoah, Your Tongue Determines Your Destiny, Shirley Mitchell, Fabulous After 50, and Robin Bertram has a miracle testimony healed from ALS.
Former Navy Chaplain Gordon James Klingenschmitt took a stand to defend religious freedom by daring to pray publicly in Jesus' name. Now he helps you by reporting the news, discerning the spirits, and praying the scriptures. Would you pray with us? Here's Dr. Chaps.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. Chaps, joined now by another Christian author at the NRB convention, April Shenandoah, who has written this book, Your Tongue Determines Your Destiny. Now let's figure out what this means. April, welcome to the program.
Thank you. It's so good to see you.
I have a tongue, you have a tongue, but you're talking about destiny here. That's a pretty big word. What on earth does this mean?
Our tongue is the greatest tool we have. People speak so negative. They speak like they're spitting in the wind, and they don't realize what they're doing when they speak negative. God spoke the moon and stars into place, and he has given us the same authority to speak things into being. And people, I know that sounds new agey or culty or whatever to some people.
But it's in the Bible. That's what God did when he spoke and the sun and the moon and the stars were created. And the subtitle is, Say What You Want and Receive It Supernaturally.
Yes.
Now this is by Harrison House Publisher, forward by Charles Capps, who was one of the Word of Faith movement founders. Right? And
yes.
I've read some of his books. How did he inform your take on this book?
He loved the book. And in fact, his book, The Tongue of Creative Force, you might remember that book, changed my life. Besides the Bible, that book changed my life. And so I only wanted him to write the foreword. I really wanted him.
Which is something he never did in his life.
He had never endorsed any book, so I'm so blessed. He loved it. He said he didn't have to change a word. And so he encouraged me. He even called me sometimes and gave me little tips. And
he made an exception and endorsed your book.
Yes, yes, yes.
Well, that is supernatural. You spoke something into existence and it happened.
That's right. That's right. That's right. But we really do have to watch what we say. Now, people say, well, I get a cold every year. I get the flu every year. Or I don't have enough money to ever pay my bills. They're speaking that into existence. Just speak provision. Say, thank you, Lord, for my provision, for my bills being paid. Thank you, thank you. I got a van, a high-top van. I wanted it for my ministry. And I didn't have the money or I didn't have credit. This was several years back. And I said, Lord, I really want a van. And so then I just started thanking him. I'd see on the highway the vans, and I'd say, that's the one, Lord. That's the one, Lord. I want one just like that. Thank you for bringing it. Thank you. I got that van miraculously, debt-free. So it's not that I want to just call things in, like I don't want a new Mercedes or, you know, a mansion or $1 million.
So there's a limit to this because it can get into greed. And people,
yes.
People criticize some teachers as non-biblical, and they say that they're name it and claim it or blab it and grab it or confessing Cadillacs, but you're not trying to do that.
Not at all. Not at all. I just know my need, and I thank him for it, for my provision. I'm employed by God. So he takes care of me.
That's more like an attitude of gratefulness, which we all ought to have.
Yes, I am very grateful. Even when I eat my food, I'm really grateful the last few years. And I've never gone without food, but he has put it on my heart to be grateful, like you said, for everything. Everything.
And that gratitude out of the overflow of your heart, your mouth speaks that.
Yes, it does. And I hear people speak all the time, and it's not up to me to go up to people and say, don't say that. But it's true. I have friends and relatives that speak so negative, and whatever they're speaking, that's what they're living. What we speak today will be the life you live tomorrow. I truly believe that.
So I notice in your biography you're also a woman of prayer. Talk about your prayer life.
Without prayer life, you don't really have a relationship with God or Jesus Christ. You have to have prayer time. You have to sit in the presence of the Lord. The anointing comes. When people get healed when the anointing comes, that breaks the yoke, right? Right? So it's a relationship. It's not God's out there somewhere. We have a personal relationship with Jesus, as you do, of course. You understand all that. But some people just don't get it. They don't get it till they get it. I didn't get it till I got it. you know.
Yeah.
And
you impressed me as a charismatic. You received the baptism of the Holy Ghost?
Yes, absolutely. I did one day. This lady would not leave me alone. Well, I went to this prayer group every Thursday in Beverly Hills, and she'd always want to pray for my prayer language. And I said, if God wants me to have it, I'm open, but I didn't know anything about it. So every week, and one week she said, now let me pray one more time. Nothing happened. But on the way home, I'm driving home, and it came up out of my belly, out of my mouth, and I was like, it was like a high, is what I assumed.
And you began speaking in tongues.
I spoke in tongues. I couldn't stop. I couldn't stop for a long time. And then when I did stop, you know, the first thing I said, Lord, now if this is not of you, take it away. Because, you know, years ago, people would say it's of the devil. Right. Well, the devil doesn't make you want to read the word and pray and spend time with the Lord.
And talk about Jesus.
And talk about Jesus.
Right.
That's right. Because now I'm hungry. I want more and more and more of Jesus. I'm hungry.
So the Lord never did take that away, did he?
Never. He increased it. He increased it. Yes, absolutely. And the ambassador of prayer ministry came from, do you remember Jesse Helm?
The name rings a bell.
Jesse Helm. He was senator of North Carolina.
Oh, of course. Yeah, Senator Helm.
He's passed away now. But I had met Sam Nunn, a senator in California, and the words ambassador of prayer kept rolling around in my head. And I thought, I wonder what that's all about. Then when I met Sam Nunn, I said, you need an ambassador of prayer for Washington. And he says, write me a letter and tell me that. I'm going to give it to Jesse Helms because he's in charge of ambassadorships. So I did. And Jesse Helms' office called me. And I went there. And they said, what do you want? And it was taking me aback because I didn't want anything. I just wanted a seal of approval so I could get in more doors as ambassador of prayer.
Wow. Yes. And did that happen?
And it wasn't official. But they said, just print cards and be the ambassador of prayer. And the next administration, then we can make it official. This was during the Clinton years.
Yeah.
So the next administration, Bush, right? Yes.
Yeah.
Of course, I didn't do anything about it. I just said, hey, I'm ambassador of prayer.
You already had the cards printed at that time.
I had the cards printed.
If God calls it to you, you're not even going to ask someone
that's
else.
Right. That's right. Yes. But I feel sad for people that don't pray because they don't know what they're missing. They have no idea. That just talk to Mark 11:23, right?
Okay.
Pray. You can move that mountain. Whatever that challenge is in your life, you can speak to it. You can tell God, say, thank you, God, for helping me fix this, or fix it, Father. He's my daddy.
Amen.
And that's when I realized when he is my father, my daddy, that changed everything. 180 degrees. But yes, Mark 11:23, that's the main one. Pray without doubting in your heart, and you shall have what you say.
And if Jesus said it, it must be true.
Yeah.
The Bible says that, and your book is titled Your Tongue Determines Your Destiny, April Shenandoah. Do you have a website?
I do, aprilshenandoah.com.
There you go. I'm Dr. Chaps, and our website is prayinjesusname.org. We'll be right back after this short break.
Giving you a megaphone in Washington, D.C., Dr. Chaps will be right back. Take action today. Dr. Chaps needs you to sign an important online petition.
Today I want to invite you to sign an important petition to Congress to protect military chaplains, especially their right to pray publicly in Jesus' name. If you remember my story, you know that I was vindicated by Congress in 2006 after I took a principled stand for the right to pray in Jesus' name. I even demanded my own misdemeanor court-martial. And finally, Congress agreed with me and reversed the bad Navy policy. But Congress never did pass a positive law to let chaplains pray according to their conscience. Let's take action today for religious freedom. Would you sign that petition with me? Visit prayinjesusname.org. Again, that's prayinjesusname.org.
Please visit prayinjesusname.org and sign today's petition right now. Again, visit prayinjesusname.org to sign our petition right now.
You know, people ask me, Chaps, we're watching on this network. We've already set our DVR to record your shows, but our friends don't have this network, or maybe they can't watch at this time. Did you know we are on demand on 10 different platforms? You can tell your friends to find this show, PIJN News, on their Roku box or their Amazon Fire box. Just look under the religion or news categories. Or maybe you have a smartphone, or your friends or grandchildren can find us on Android TV, Google TV, Smart TV, or iTunes. Of course, we're always on the internet. Look for us on YouTube or Facebook or Twitter, Or better yet, subscribe to our daily email alerts at PrayInJesusName.org. It's important that you share all of these available platforms with your friends so we can mobilize all of the body of Christ to pray the news and change the world. Would you join us? Visit PrayInJesusName.org to learn more.
Defending your religious freedom, here is Dr. Chaps.
Welcome back. I'm joined now by a new friend and Christian author, Shirley Mitchell, who has written three books, Fabulous After 50, get the titles of these, Sensational After 60, and Radiant After 70. You would never guess by looking at her, but she's written these books to encourage women of a certain age. Shirley, welcome to the program.
Thank you. I'm so glad to be here.
Well, I'm honored to meet you, and please introduce your guest.
Cruiser Small. He's my agent.
He's your literary agent. So you sell books, you write books, and I just am a humble TV host. I want to interview Shirley about these books. But why Fabulous After 50? This was the first book that you wrote, and what's it about?
Fabulous After 50, it seems like people, when they reach 50, especially women, that they get this in their head that they're old. But it's really just a stepping stone into the future. And I grew up as a Christian in a Christian home and have had a wonderful life. And your spirit grows as you grow older. And your life becomes larger and more exciting. And so I wanted to share that with women. You know, 50 is not the jumping off place for being young. It's really time to fly.
So I happen to be 48. I'm not ashamed to admit it. But when I was 40, somebody in my family, probably my mother, sent me a funny birthday card that showed me over the hill at age 40. And there's this whole this idea that once you reach a certain age that you're over the hill, that it's all downhill from here. And, you know, my belly got bigger and my hairline receded and my life was essentially over, I think was the intended joke behind the funny birthday card. But that's not true, is it?
It is not true, because when you are in God's hands and you feel the joy of Him and the expectations of the future, and you know, watch your children and grandchildren grow into these beautiful people, it's an up time. It isn't a bad time. And as you grow in Christ, it just gets more exciting to live. I have 18 grandchildren.
18 grandchildren. How many kids did you have?
Three.
Well, I mean, they were productive. Somebody did some multiplying there. I'm just doing the math in my head.
Well, what we're having now is my grandchildren are having children, so that there's some greats in there.
You have some greats in there.
Yes.
So it's not just Fabulous After 50. Now it's Radiant After 70.
Yes, and you know, being 70 is wonderful. You have a broader view of life, and you have the ability to understand what's important and what's not important, and you're getting closer to Jesus, you're getting closer to heaven, you're getting closer to when you're spending eternity, and I've got lots of people over there waiting for me.
Well, and this is an important time, not only to make decisions about your future and about eternity. We want to make sure everyone goes to heaven and that they've accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior.
Yes.
But it's also a season where you're imparting wisdom to the next generation. Talk about your relationship with your grandchildren.
I have a great relationship with my grandchildren. They call me Gigi. They fight over who's going to sit by me or who's going to go with me to the movies. And, you know, when you get older, that's a lot of fun to have to have people fight over you and want to be with you and watch your genes grow.
Now, you probably feel like the center of attention, but I bet you make each one of them the center of your attention.
I do. I spend a lot of attention on them and their joys and teaching them about Jesus. it's important to me.
And what are the other themes in the books? I mean, do each of the three books say the same thing, or are they different?
They're different. I think in my Christian walk, I grew up in a family in the cotton fields in Alabama, and when grandmother and grandfather and uncles and aunts and cousins, and we all worked the fields together, but we went to church, and my grandmother played the piano, and my grandfather, he was a stutterer, but he sung, he led the choir anyway, and prayer, we had prayers at our meals, and it was just a love situation, and that's how faith grows into, you know, enjoying life when you're even older. Even I'm now 78, and I'm still loving life.
I can just guess you've already begun work on something after 80. Elegant after 80. We're coming up with names.
Yes. But there's a lot of our generation in America growing older, and I think as we hold on to Christ and our families and looking forward to our future in heaven, there's a lot more spirituality being broadcast, like you broadcast it, and in our churches and in our homes. And sometimes we have to help some of the young people who get off on the wrong track and pull them back into Christ.
Now, these books are published by Whitaker House, but how can people buy them? Where do they find your book?
I'll let my agent tell you about that.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Small. Tell us
that. You can find Shirley's books at Barnes & Noble, Amazon, and each one of the books has their own website, fabulousafter50.com, sensationalafter60.com, radiantafter70.com, and you can also go to our radio show website, which is agingoutsidethebox.com, and find them there as well.
AgingOutsideTheBox.com. What an intriguing title.
It is. Shirley was at a conference when that name came up. Somebody said, oh, you ought to name your show Aging Outside the Box. So we did. And it kind of encompasses all of those age brackets, the 50, 60, and 70 books that Shirley has written, because she's lived every part of those three categories. So many years into it, then she started writing the book. And so they're really interesting books, and they got some great recipes in there too if you like to cook.
Hey, you can't go wrong with intriguing recipes. I love food.
My agent is a lighthouse chef from Maine, and we met at a Christian conference. So he knows all about good food.
Very good. You got to appreciate that. All right. Our guest has been Shirley Mitchell, author of these three great books. You can find them at fabulousafter50.com and other websites, as she mentioned. I'm Dr. Chaps. Our website is prayinjesusname.org. I'll be right back.
This is PIJN News, defending your religious freedom. Dr. Chaps will be right back.
Do you ever pray and sometimes you feel like your prayers are hitting the ceiling and they don't get to God, or maybe you don't get the result that you hoped for? I'm Dr. Chaps, and I want to make available to you a new resource, a four-part video Bible teaching series on how to pray effective prayers. Did you know God has given us instructions in the Bible? For example, in 1 Timothy 2, there are four different Greek words for four different kinds of prayers: supplication, petition, intercession, and thanksgiving. If you don't understand the way God teaches us to pray, then we cannot expect the result for which we hope. I'm asking you to get this important Bible video teaching series on DVD for a suggested donation of only $30. Call us right now at 866-OBEY-GOD. Again, that's 866-OBEY-GOD. Or visit our website, prayinjesusname.org, and get this important video resource for your family. Call us right now.
Empowering you, the grassroots activist. Here is Dr. Chaps.
Welcome back. We're here at NRB, and we are telling inspirational stories like the one written by my new friend, Robin Bertram, who is the author of this book, No Regrets. Robin, welcome to the program.
Thank you very much. I'm excited to be with you today.
So you have a couple of interesting stories. The first one, No Regrets, is the subtitle here. How loving deeply and living passionately can impact your legacy forever. What was the inspiration behind this book?
Well, my father on his deathbed looked me in the eye and he said, Robin, he said, I have no regrets. And at age 84, that puzzled me. And not only did it puzzle me.
You don't look like you're 84.
No, my father. It really puzzled me because I wondered, how can a man possibly live that many years and be able to say, I have no regrets? So it took me on a journey, and that journey was to investigate how you can possibly say you have no regrets. So I started to investigate his life, and certainly he had built a legacy through Jesus Christ, the love he had for the Lord. But to leave a legacy, you have to live a legacy. And my father lived a legacy out in front of me. He was a godly man, and he taught me what it means to love deeply. He taught me what it means to live passionately for the Lord. And through that journey, I really felt the Lord call me to put that in a book, because so many people need to understand the importance of living a legacy so that you can leave a legacy.
What was your father's name and title?
My father's name was Reverend Paul A. Maddie. He was a pastor for 50 years. He planted 5 churches and he sang in gospel groups across the country. So I grew up as a PK kid, and church was part of our DNA. But he, on his at his funeral, I had person after person in line coming by his casket telling me what he meant in their life. And it was so impactful. And I thought, I need to share what I've learned from my father. And so that was a personal journey, and it was very exciting to put
so
that in paper.
In summary, his legacy was not just to be a great dad to you,
right,
but he impacted so many individual lives that he changed the complexion of his entire community.
Absolutely, absolutely. And it was a powerful time for me. I felt like I was at a wedding celebration instead of a funeral. And I thought, that's the way you should live your life. Loving people, you know, we think of love, we just think of on this shallow idea, but Apostle Paul taught us how to love in 1 Corinthians. Are you jealous? Are you envious? Do you try to one-up another person, or do you esteem them higher than yourselves? And so I have in the book a 30-day love challenge where I ask you, the reader, to take a look at your life just for 30 days and document where am I excelling in love and where am I failing in love. And by the end of that 30 days, you'll have a different opinion of how you should live your life daily.
And the book title is No Regrets. It's going to be published by Charisma House in June of 2017.
Yes.
Now, having said that, I want you to tell our audience your other story, which you were sharing with me. There was a dramatic physical healing in your life, and God did a miracle.
Yes, he did.
How did it start?
One day I woke up and I went to reach for a glass of water and I could not lift the glass. So I thought that I had been volunteering to paint for a friend, and I thought I had pulled a muscle. My sister and my niece dragged me to the doctor, to a walk-in clinic, St. Joseph's, and the doctor looked in my eyes and he said, I'm very sorry to tell you this, but it's neurological. Sent me to Mayo. Mayo left me with 4 diagnoses. After investigation, they took 3 off the table.
And these are the best doctors in America.
In the country, absolutely. And they left 1 diagnosis on the table, and that was a fatal, non-treatable disease of Lou Gehrig's.
ALS.
ALS, very scary. And
that's like a death sentence. How long did they give you?
Well, they said two years is the life expectancy from the diagnosis. So I went home. I said, I'm not even going to the doctor until I'm anointed and prayed over by my church. And then I started to look in Scripture. I started to quote every promise of healing in Scripture, and I did it daily. I even taped my prayer to God, because I thought, if I cannot speak, I want my prayers to go forth whether I can speak or not.
You might, if in your debilitated state, be able to press the play
yes.
button so God would still hear your voice
yes.
praying for him to intervene and heal your body.
Yes. And through that journey, a year and a half later, I waited to die for a year and a half, thus the book, No Regrets. All of that passion that I felt from the healing journey, reading scripture, it came forth, and God did heal me. He did a miraculous thing. I was 5 minutes away from my house and could not figure out how to get home. So the symptoms were real, the issue was real, and I praise Him today, because without God, I would not be here.
So how many years ago was that?
About two and a half years ago.
And what symptoms do you have today?
I have no other symptoms, no symptoms. Mayo dismissed me and they said, we cannot explain this, but there's no further damage.
But they never went through a treatment regimen or anything like that?
There was nothing to, they have no treatment.
No treatment.
Let me get this straight. 2.5 years ago, they gave you 2 years to live.
Yes.
And they said, there's no cure, you have ALS, we're the best doctors in America, we know it's neurological, go home and die.
Wait for it to get worse. Wait for it to get worse.
And God healed you.
He healed me.
Without medicine.
And He healed me through faith and prayer. There was no medicine to take.
And you not only didn't die, today you're thriving. You're full of energy.
Yes, and thankful. Very thankful.
And you're writing books.
Yes.
And you're continuing your father's legacy.
Yes.
God is great.
He is great. God, he is great.
God did a miracle here. Yes, this is a supernatural healing by faith alone.
It was, absolutely. And I give Him all the glory. I would not be here alive today had it not been for that miracle.
So somebody in that TV land right there is watching this interview and they're sick.
Yes.
And they've been given bad news by a doctor.
I can speak to you right now. If you will stand by faith and believe God's word and His promises, shut off the voices of doubt and trust God for your healing. He is a God that heals today, and your faith can take you to that place in Him where you will be totally restored. I pray in Jesus' name that you're touched and healed this very day. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Our guest has been Robert Bertram. She is the author of No Regrets, How Loving Deeply and Living Passionately Can Impact Your Legacy Forever. Thank you. Today I want to invite you to sign an important petition to Congress to protect military chaplains, especially their right to pray publicly in Jesus' name. If you remember my story, you know that I was vindicated by Congress in 2006 after I took a principled stand for the right to pray in Jesus' name. But Congress never did pass a positive law to let chaplains pray according to their conscience. Would you sign that petition with me? Let's take action today.
Dr. Chaps needs your financial support to stay on the air. Would you please send your best donation today? Please visit PrayInJesusName.org to donate online. Or you can mail a check to Pray in Jesus Name Ministries, Post Office Box 77077, Colorado Springs, Colorado 80970. You can also call us toll-free right now at 866-OBEY-GOD. That's 866-OBEY-GOD. Please sign up for our free emails at PrayInJesusName.org. Again, that's PrayInJesusName.org.